this video, I want to talk about the new sales follow-up system that's part of FM Starting Point. Now, this new feature was added starting with FM Starting Point version 4.1. So if you have a version prior to 4.1, you're not going to have this capability. So let's take a look at this. I'm going to click on the Contacts button right here. And what we've done is we've built in the new follow-up system, which is this button right here and this button right here. Now, you see these right here, but the follow-up system is actually a system that is optional and can be turned on or off. So let me just show you that real quick before we get too far along. I can go back to Preferences here, and I can show that we have the context follow-up system enabled here. If it's actually disabled where we say no, we go back to Contacts, then we're missing those navigational points there. Of course, if you're customizing FM Starting Point, you can always delete these permanently out of your copy. It's just a matter of what you want to do. So I'm going to go ahead and turn it back on so we can see how this works. So here I am in FM Starting Point. We have the follow-up system. So what are the follow-ups? Well, the follow-up's ability for us to chase this person down and set a date in the future for the follow-up. As you can see right here in the top right corner, we also have this indicator right here that indicates that we should have followed up with this person 19 days ago. So how does this work? Well, we can go here, we can press follow-up, and it allows us to see the last follow-up date right here. In fact, if I want to put the current date in there, like we talked to the person today, I can press that button right here. Now, with most systems, they're going to ask you to actually look at a calendar and pick a date in the future, or actually to manually go in here and type the date, that type of thing. And I find that personally to be a real hassle. So we've been working with this new follow-up system for a while, and we actually use this internally at RC Consulting as well, because it's so intuitive and so simple. I don't worry about the date in the future that I'm going to chase this person down on. All I do is think about the amount of time that I want to transpire before I actually reach out to this person again. So of course we have 3 days, 5 days, 7 days. I can press this right here, and it sets this automatically for 7 days in the future. Of course, these are all the common things. You could get back to someone maybe in 2 weeks, or maybe in a month, or a month and a half, or maybe 3 months, or half a year. Just depends on what you're looking for. Of course, I can click any of these, and it's going to update that up here automatically. Now, another option within FM Starting Point is the ability to click on and assign staff for a follow-up. Say that you're in a central office and you get a phone call from a customer and they say, well, we're interested, but we'd like to talk to one of your people in, say, 30 days. Well, you can specify that we're going to follow up in 30 days, but we can also specify a certain person that should be following up with this contact. Additionally, you can specify a note. So I can press the cancel button here, the clear notes button, or the update button. Now I press the update button, so it sets an internal follow-up date for this person. We see it reflected up here in the top corner of the screen. We also see that right here there's a new entry in our note system that actually makes a historical note about this follow-up setting that we've made. It's also made a note in FM Starting Point's built-in to-do or action item management system. Now we call it to-dos here. I can press here and we can see that we've set a follow-up for this date in the future right here. Now that being said, we can also look at all the to-dos by coming back over here and looking at the to-do list here. Now, of course, these are all the to-dos for various people within the organization, also with specified date. Right here is the to-do that we just created. Pretty slick. I can also press this button right here, and it's going to jump to that contact record in the system. So it's pretty slick from that standpoint. I also want to note that as you add to-dos into FM Starting Point, it's going to put those on your calendar for you. So as you can see, we actually have the follow-up right here. Pretty slick. Now, if you're a salesperson or you're working with your sales team, they're going to generally prefer to pop up a punch list of all the contacts they need to follow up for today. The easiest way to do that is to select this button right here and bring up a punch list right here. This is going to show us the number of days until the contact is due, and of course, the negative number means that we're already behind. But we can actually go here, we can reach out this person, call them, and then right here on the screen, I can make an additional follow-up. Say, for example, that 34 days ago, we should have talked to this person, but we've been slacking it pretty bad, and we're just now getting in. Maybe our entire sales team was out on vacation for an entire month and a half. Well, I can go right here real quick and say, okay, follow up with this person here, follow up with this person in 2 weeks because they might be interested in pulling the trigger, okay? Now I can go back over here to the calendar My update is already here and made available live in the calendar system in FM Starting Point. Pretty cool. So as you interact with this, it's going to make live changes to the system. Now it's important to note that each person can have only one follow-up date that's scheduled. So if you want to follow up with this person every 2 weeks, we really didn't engineer it with that in mind. Every person, like this person right here, is going to have a single automatic to-do that's managed, and those to-dos show up in the calendar. Now, as a point of clarification, my engineers are sitting here over my shoulder micromanaging this video, and I don't want to get it wrong. To be very clear, you can create one follow-up for each person, and that follow-up actually results in a single to-do, which shows up on the to-do list and also on the calendar. And now they're all smiles and they're happy. Ding! Now keep in mind, you can have multiple to-dos for a contact, but you're going to have to add those additional to-dos manually, as opposed to the fully automatic one. Right, Zach?
Right on, baby.
That's correct. Now, what if you want to clear out the follow-up entirely? Now, keep in mind, this cancel follow-up button right here is going to clear out this follow-up and the associated to-do action item for this particular person. So I can press this right here, and this list now is updated. Now, something else cool with this list I want to point out. Right here, you can press this button to pop up the email dialog for this individual user. Now, if you've been busy setting up your own email templates, kind of like what we've done with our own copies of FM Starting Point, then you can easily jump here, specify an email template, and then press the send button very easily. Of course, keep in mind that after we send the email, it's going to log that email right here automatically. Now, currently, you'll notice at the top corner of the screen, there's no information right here. That's because we actually completed that follow-up, right? And by sending the email, the system makes a note that we did complete the follow-up. If you want an additional follow-up, well, you can simply close this window, go back to this person right here. Notice the system is highlighting for us that we really need to take action here. Either we cancel the follow-up entirely, or we can set another follow-up. Maybe we didn't make contact, so we sent an email saying, hey, just thinking of you, don't forget about us here at Acme Widgets. And we can follow up with them, say, in another 2 weeks. Perfect. Now, by pressing the refresh and resort follow-up list button, it's going to give me the list of the most critical follow-ups that we need to perform, sorted by date. So the very oldest ones, all the way as we scroll forward to ones that are in the future. Just because we have one specified for next week doesn't mean that we can't go out right now and reach out to that person. We can go ahead and do it just like this and say, oh, we made contact with them and they want to hear from us in 3 days. I press that button, and the system has updated itself automatically. Additionally, your sales team will be able to go up here at the top and select their name at the top and see only the records that are assigned to them. Now, we don't have any security in here to prevent one salesperson from seeing another salesperson's records. However, if you have concerns about that, we have several videos that talk about record-level security and process-level security, and they'll be very applicable to this type of situation where you want to restrict access for your sales staff. Now, if you have a fairly small sales team and they're not trying to knife each other in competition, well, then you're probably okay and you don't have to worry about it. But if you have a large sales team and there's large competitive bonuses where one sales team might get a bonus and cause another sales team to not get a bonus, then you might want to think about record level security here. So once again, we have those videos. I know because one of my sharp watching viewers jumped all over my case about that, and since we're so customer service oriented here at Learning FileMaker, we shot those videos for you. Now moving along, we've identified the sales staff at the top of the screen, we've narrowed the found set down, and that helps focus your sales team right there. Now one thing they're going to want to do is if you can get them a big enough screen, they're going to want to keep this list of follow-ups on screen at one time. And then off to the left side, they can press the email button if they want to bring up the email template system that's built into FM Starting Point. It's really handy to keep this list up on screen at one time and to kind of work your way through it, notating that you've followed up with people and that you've completed that follow-up, and then work your way down the list. You can press the envelope button to instantly email. You can also press the arrow button right here to pop open that contact record open in their own window. Now the idea here is that you interact with this window right here, You can even email from right here, and then you close the window and you move on. So the idea is that you keep this master list open, you work off this list from top to bottom, or however you want to work on it, until you're satisfied that this list has been serviced for the day. And then you can, of course, navigate off and go do something else. But the idea is that you keep this list running and you service the context on this list. And then once you service it, then you, based upon the conversation or maybe the lack of the conversation or the lead potential, you're going to set your follow-up that you contacted them today and that you're going to hit them up in 2 or 3 weeks, however you're going to do that. So pretty slick stuff. So enjoy the new follow-up system we built for you in FM Starting Point. Once again, FM Starting Point is available for the amazingly low price of free. So just keep that in mind as you play with it.